Also briefly discuss how to prepare financial statement using the concepts of the account classification what you have learned in journal entries. While doing journal entries, you have categorized the accounts into three types. Basically, we have real accounts, we have personal accounts, we have real accounts, personal accounts and nominal accounts. Now, if you can identify them clearly, this real accounts and personal accounts are usually taken in balance sheet. They are taken in balance sheet. If a real account is showing debit balance, you take it in balance sheet. You take it in balance sheet, asset side, balance sheet, asset side, which I am writing as balance sheet, BSA. Personal account, if it is showing debit balance, we take it in balance sheet on asset side. If a personal account is showing credit balance, we take it in balance sheet on liability side. Remember, all nominal accounts appear, they appear only in trading or P&L account. They appear only in trading or P&L account. If a nominal account is showing debit balance, if they are showing debit balances, I write here, if nominal accounts are showing debit balances, take them on debit side of trading or P&L account. Now, when trading, when P&L, we will be discussing later. Now, if your nominal account is showing credit balance, then take it on credit side of trading or P&L account. Then, continuing further, few more things to remember when we do final accounts is recalling of your accounting equation. Recalling your accounting equation would be important because the balance sheet what we prepare is nothing but prepared on the accounting equation concept. So, balance sheet is always representing your accounting equation, which states that capital plus liabilities is equals to assets. So, the same accounting equation we represent in a statement form, which roughly I am putting here as a pro forma. So, it is a simple format, T-shaped format like an account, only without your date and LF columns. You can simply say it is the format of an account without date and your JF column. So here, this is the balance sheet. So you would be mentioning balance sheet of so and so person as on so and so date. It is prepared on a particular date. It is prepared on a particular date, but not for a period. So, on the left hand side you have liabilities, then this is the amount column, then on the right hand side you record all your assets. This is what is the simple format of your balance sheet. Now, this is based on your accounting equation. Then, moving on to the next equation that is useful for us while preparing final accounts would be, though we rarely use it, but still it would be useful. We say that this is used related to goods. Now, initially, most of you in my explanation would have understood the terms purchases, and we also come across the word opening stock, and then we have the word sales. Now here I am cutting this word sales and I am using the word cost of goods sold. Then I am using the word closing stock. am using the word closing stock. Now in journal entries, we have come across the word purchases and we have also come across the word sales. So these two we have treated at that time as real account. Now what is this purchase of goods representing? It is purchase of those tangible items which you intend to sell and earn profit. So once you purchase, you are getting some tangible things. At the same time when you are selling them, these tangible things are moving out from you. That means they are getting exhausted. So at the end of the year, you are going to compare the inflow of cash through sales with the outflow of cash for those goods which are sold. So therefore, at the end of the year, please remember that what you have treated as personal account, sorry, real accounts have to be considered as nominal accounts. So at the end of the year accounting period, we consider purchase of goods and sale of goods as nominal accounts. So based on this concept, we have the equation that opening stock of goods, opening stock of goods, I am using the word here net purchases. Now what is net purchases? Net purchases is nothing but purchases minus purchase returns. Purchases minus purchases returns is equal to cost of goods sold. Now what is exactly cost of goods sold? For example, if you say cost of goods sold, let us say I have purchased 10 pence at the rate rupees 6. That means my total purchases is equals to 60 rupees. Now then I have sold 8 pence. I have sold 8 pence at the rate rupees 10. That means here my sales is 80 rupees. Now this is representing my sales. So it is involving, the sales is involving two parts. One is cost price of pence and also some profit element. So when it is involving some profit element, if I remove the profit element, that means I said I purchased my pen at rupees 6. So when I sold 8 pence, the cost of this 8 pence would be 8 into 6. That is, cost of 8 pence would be 8 into 6, 48 rupees. So cost of goods sold is nothing but the cost element of the sales value. How much? If you remove the profit, the cost element that is left over is nothing but your cost of goods sold. So let us put the same example in our equation. For here I am presuming we don't have opening stock, so I am taking it as nil. Now my purchases is rupees 60. Now this is, let us say for our understanding, 10 pence. Now what is the, how many pence did I sell? 8 pence. I sold 8 pence. So my cost of those 8 pence sold would be 48. Leftover is called, how many are left over? Out of 10 pence, I sold 8 pence. So 2 should be left over. Naturally, it would be 12. So always your equation will balance. This will not directly use, but in some cases we need to use this. You will be using mostly in some short problems. So this is other equation which you have to remember while doing final accounts. If you carefully remember this entire equation itself we will be writing as trading account. This equation itself we will be writing as trading account, and also some along with some direct expenses. So direct expenses plus, I can say, this equation will be written as trading account. A simple way to understand trading account is, we will write all these items and also direct expenses which constitute your trading account. However, in trading account, we won't be recording cost of goods sold. Rather, this cost of goods sold, we will record this cost of goods sold in trading account as sales. We don't record it as cost of goods sold, rather we record it as sales. This is only to ensure that you remember the items that come in your trading account. What items come in your trading account? Opening stock will come, you can take purchases, cost of goods sold will be coming as sales, and closing stock also will be coming in trading account along with some direct expenses. We will be discussing what are direct expenses later. Now further, you need to remember what are the important things you should remember to prepare trading P&L and balance sheet. First of all, you need a trial balance. Now, what is the trial balance? You already discussed in the chapter trial balance. So, if at all you have a trial balance, preparation of final accounts becomes easy. If a trial balance exists, you can say the preparation of final accounts becomes easy. Now, second, you need to make some adjustments. Now, these adjustments you can make before preparing trial balance, or after preparing trial balance, Now, if you do the adjustments before preparing the trial balance, then you will have only one trial balance from which you will take. So if you have this directly, you will process the information into trading